that for organizing this workshop. And I'm very happy to visit Korea. This is really a nice country, a very beautiful country, with nice people, friendly, and very clean environments. I hope to come here more times in the future. So the title of the talk today is the stabilizing effect of convention in incompatible flows. I just changed the title a little bit. And most of the work I joined with Professor Tom Ho from Caltech, Professor Humini from University of Colorado at Boulder, and my former PhD Center of Advisor Professor Yin Zhou from Stanford University. He will also give a talk on the wave equation soon after. Okay, Levi Stokes' equations was written down by Lavoisier nearly 200 years ago. And later, a lot of other mathematicians were also involved in deriving this equation, including Cauchy and Boson. And the current form we are using is due to Stokes. He derived the Levi Stokes equation in 1845. And this is the incompatible Levi Stokes equations. Here, U is the velocity field, P is scale pressure. And U sub T means the time derivative of the velocity field. And the first equation is the balance equation for momentum. Here, mu is the viscosity coefficient. And the second equation, that is U equals zero, means that the fluid flow is incompressible. And to solve this equation, we also need the initial data, U zero. And physically, interesting initial data must be in two space. And the wave solution was constructed by the way of 1934 by the modification method. The wave space solution is in a space of infinity in time L2, intersected with L2H1, which satisfies the global energy inequality. And later on, from 1951, Hall constructed the wave solution for Lewis equations by Galilean method in the case of boundary domain. And then the basic question for Lewis Stokes equation is that, is there a global classical solutions starting from a smooth electric data with finite energy? And now this question is still one of Clay's many problems. And this is a description of Lewis Stokes equations on the website of Clay's Institute of Mathematical Sciences. Mathematicians and physicists believe that an explanation for and predicting all, both the brief and turbulence can be found through understanding our solution to the various Stokes equations. The challenge is to make substantial progress on our mathematical theory. So this is a very simple list of the contents of the talk. And I will firstly give a brief review on magnetic loan results. Of course, there is a lot of needs of known results in this field, and I cannot list all of them. But I will try to list those results, most related to our results. And then I will discuss heuristics on the global reflecting way as finite time graph. And at last, I will present our results on the stabilizing effect of convection. So it is well known that if the data is small compared to the viscosity coefficients, then you have global regularity for Lewis Stokes equations. For example, on 1984, Cato proved that if the electric data is in L3, and as long as the electric data is small, then you have global regularity. And on 2001, Cotton Cato proved that if the BNO minus lambda of the electric data is small, then you have global regularity of Lewis Stokes equations. You also have global regularity in some ways, in some special case, for example, the axisymmetric case. On 1968, independently, Nadine Gaia and these two Japanese mathematicians proved that for axisymmetric electric data, the Lewis equation is globally well posed. If the initial, of course, the small component of the velocity field is zero. If the initial small component of the velocity field is not zero, on 2007, Tom Ho and Kuo-Ming-Li constructed a family of essentially null solution for the Lewis Stokes equations. And later on, Tom Ho, Kuo-Ming-Li, and I gave a generalization of the results. An important step towards understanding the relative properties of the very powerful solutions was a localization in space of the risk particle relative results. This program was started by Siegel, and later on developed further by Catherine Kuhn-Nierenberg in 1982. They studied the suitable solutions and they proved that the one-dimensional Hausdorff measure of the set of space-time singular polynomials of any single wave solution is zero. And they found from one medium the neural simplified proof. And the most possible candidates for Bloch proposed by the ring was a set similar solution of this form. And this solution, if capital U is in R3, this kind of set similar solution was excluded by these three classifications. And they also check for an extension of this result. Now I also want to mention two criteria which is relevant and extensively used in the field of relativistic equations. The first one is Newton quantum criteria on 1984. They proved that if the accumulation of an invisible velocity is finite, then U is smooth up to the time t, even for all the equation. And this criteria was slightly improved by Kalulu on 2000. The Eigenvalue law was replaced by the BM law. Another criteria that was also extensively used is service criteria. This criteria is due to a lot of persons, including Surrey, Perlman, that is Gaia, and Stubbe. They put that for the recall wave solution U, if used in this space, LQLP space, so that the LQLP law of U is dimensionless, then U is smooth after cap T. In the Bohmann case, P is 3 is independent and true. And in this case, was only proved on 2003 by these three classifications. Kuhn-Nierenberg's theory implies that if U is bounded by this quantity, note that this quantity is spinning invariant due to the lateral spin of relativistic equations. If C is a small constant, then U is smooth at this point. This describes the Bloch rate of U. In the case of big constant C, it is still open now. But in the asymmetric case, we have some progress recently. But these four main authors, Chen, String, Chan, and Yo. And also, these three explanations also have similar results in this aspect. And so, despite a lot of efforts by mathematicians, the global level is still open. So, is there a finite time graph? It is known that the most possible candidates for finite time Bloch is the self-similar solutions proposed by the Ring, but this candidate was excluded by these three mathematicians. There are also a lot of numerical strong evidence, for example, Kerr on 1993, Kerr claimed that he found the strong evidence for the 3-dimensional 3D incomparable equation. And the data Kerr used was solved by LIDAR, that which is the data is the most the possible one to produce finite time Bloch. But on 2006, Tom Bowen, the Zhou Li, can do the computation even later than the simpler time that Kerr predicted, based on some kind of observations on the dynamic deletion of the linearity. So what about the regularity? I want to show two examples. The first example is the linear Schrödinger equation. And on 1998, 1999, Borghini proved this equation is globally well posed in the regular symmetric case. And on 2008, this far also proved that this equation is globally well posed in general case if the elliptic data is in H1. We want to see the scale of this equation. Suppose U is the solution of this equation, then you define U lambda of Tx in the way that you lambda equals lambda to half, u of lambda squared t lambda x. Then you find that u lambda is still a solution of this equation. And when you look at the applied estimates of this equation, you can see that the mass is conserved. And the energy is bounded, applied bounded. Here, compared to this gain, this quantity is dimensionless, so we call it is critical. But this quantity is supercritical because it has a positive dimension. We also want to look at another example, quasi-geosophic equation. And this equation was only solved on 2007 by this three-dimensional equation, and later on independently by Cafferani and Watts on 2009. For this equation, we also have a lateral spinning and two appropriately bounded quantity. The first one is infinity of theta. This quantity, of course, is dimensionless compared with this scaling. And this quantity is also conserved, but it has a positive dimension, so it is supercritical. Now, what about Larry Stokes? We see that if you solve the Larry Stokes equations, you define U lambda in this way. You have two applied estimates. The first one is the L2 law of U. The second one is the space-time L2 law of gradient U. Compared with this scale, you can even see that both the two quantities have positive dimensions. And so they are supercritical with respect to the lateral scaling of Larry Stokes equation. On 2007, Terence Hall has a root. A wide root regularity for Larry Stokes equation is half. In the root, Hall claims that to prove the global regularity for evolutionary fluid equations, basically, you need two appropriately bounded quantities. One is some good critical or subcritical quantity to get the regularity. The other one is supercritical appropriately bounded quantities to get some kind of spatial decay. But for these roots, we have just presented that you don't have any quantities appropriately bounded, which is appropriately bounded and critical. So we see that Larry Stokes equation is essentially different from those we can understand. We have understand. we hope to present some understanding on stabilizing thermal convection, because we believe that the convection term may play an essential rule in the global regularity theory of Larry Stokes equations. First of all, let us look at the incomparable equation. An important quantity for all equation is volume preserving. For simplicity, it simply reads that the vorticity equals to F vorticity zero. Here, F is the definite tensor. It is a Jacobian matrix from the Lagrangian coordinate to Euler coordinate, and it's determined equals to 1. Newton Leibniz criteria says that if vorticity is bounded, then the solution is globally classical. So if you have finite singularity, then at least one of the eigenvalues of f must go to infinity as time evolves. But the determinant f equals 1. So at least one of the values of the Gagarin tensor must also go to 0, which gives you some kind of an isotropic structure. Numerical evidence also shows that the support of maximum vorticity becomes theoretically threatened as the vortex stretching intensifies in time. This is due to convection and lead to dimension reduction or some kind of an isotropy. So since the viscosity is supercritical, it seems too weak to control the linearity. And we believe that the convection may be the real reason, may be the essential reason for responsible for the global linearity. Let us focus on anti-symmetric Larry Stokes equations. We look for solution by this form, u of tx equals to ur tzr er plus u theta e theta plus u v e z. Here r equals the square root of s1 squared plus s2 squared. But er e theta e z are the basic, the three unit vectors forming the a standard base of R3. Here ur, u theta and u theta depends on theta variable. For Lewis-Stokes equations, you can prove that if the image data is of this form, then the solution is also of this form. This solution is called anti-symmetric solutions. In the cylindrical coordinates, you can rewrite Lewis-Stokes equations in the form if u theta, vortex theta, and the push theta do not depend on theta variable. So this equation for u theta, for vortex theta, and push theta. Push theta is the swing function, and ur is defined in this way, minus pi z push theta. Uz is defined as 1 over r plus r applied to r push theta. And also, you have an expression for vorticity in the cylindrical coordinate. Why we choose anti-symmetric Lewis-Stokes equations? There are local regions that we choose that. It seems that the anti-symmetric Lewis-Stokes equations is simpler than the general Lewis-Stokes equations. I just need some of them. The first one thing important is this equation for r u theta. In this equation, r u theta is a polynomial or covariant and implied the viscosity. You can put the viscosity here and just miss it. You can even see that r u theta is conserved along the trajectory of u r z. So we have another prime bounded quantity. R u theta is in R infinity. Look that R u theta is scaling variance. So you have some kind of partial criticality for axisymmetric Lewis-Stokes equations. And the second one is that you have a pull-up rate due to these four manifestations. If u is bounded by this quantity with a constant c, then u is smooth at time t equals to 0. So if you have a finite block, then u must be bigger than this quantity, at least for sequence of Rn and Tn. The third one is that Ru is not bounded. If R is not bounded, then the Asian solution of 2D, the Asian solution of the Lewis-Stokes equation, you can plot the original solution along the sequence of Rn, so that Rn un goes to infinity. Then you get the Asian solution. You can prove the Asian solution is 2D. This is recently asked by Professor Zhang Qi from Jerusalem and Japan. In 2008, Tom Ho and Hong Yuni introduced a new set of variables, u1, v1, pz1. u1 equals to u theta over r, v1 equals to o theta over r, pz1 equals to pz theta over r. Here, if uses a smooth solution to Lewis-Stokes equation, we can prove that ur equals to 0 if r equals to 0. So this new set of variables are reasonable. And in terms of u1, v1, pz1, you can resolve the Lewis-Stokes equation in the form. It seems much simpler. And this turns out to be a four-dimensional Laplacian. Here you can formally define ur and uz in this way. And based on this equation, based on this reformulated axis-symmetric Lewis-Stokes equations, and Ho and Li constructed a 1D model. And by using all the convection terms, we can prove that the 1D model is globally composed if the emission time is good. And then they constructed a family of 7 class global solutions via this 1D model. And later on we'll do some extensions of the results. This is our results. Here, then we see theta, u theta. And what is theta? A pure orbit and all with respect to the variable. Of course, this solution is very special, but it's essentially not. And delta is a small given, given small number. And then the relation velocity field is in our two space. And then, under the relation beta is given in this form, then the little smooth equation is globally smooth. For if epsilon is sufficiently small. But if epsilon is sufficiently small, then you can find that the ratio, then as the law of the beta can be arbitrarily large. Here is the proof, the schedule of the proof, and as you can see, it's up. In the regularity theory, in the regularity analysis for those two equations, most of the efforts have focused on how to use the convection, how to use the diffusion to control the vortex scattering terms. But without using the convection terms, because we always use integrating by parts and it just goes away. We want to construct a 3D model to show that the convection term, in fact, has some kind of stabilizing effect in the 3D model in comparison to all the Lewis group equations. So, which seems to imply that the convection plays an essential role in deepening the vortex scattering terms. So, which are the role of the convection in the reformulated X-Math Lewis group equations? And this equation is very simple here. You just have the vector vortex scattering, vortex scattering. And you can formally define UR, UC, and UV in this group. In this way. Now what do you get? You still have incompressibility if you define a velocity field in this way. You still have angular identity. It's very similar to the original Lewis equation. You have linearities, single linearities, it seems quadratic in this equation. Similar as Lewis equation. You have same scaling as Lewis equation's dimension and locality. Maybe this is a dot. What is dot, right? Here is a very simple model for Lewis groups. You can just drop off the convection term in the vorticity equation of Lewis groups equations. You have this very simple equations, and they can recover you while the convolution of some curve with vorticity. For this equation, of course, we still have non-linear scaling dimension, non-locality, similar as those for Lewis group equations. But for this model, you don't have incompressibility. You don't have energy identity. So it's hard to compare this model with the original Lewis group equations. But in our model, you have almost everything, almost, of course. You have incompressibility, energy identity, a similar structure of Lewis group equations. The only thing that we don't have in 3D model is the convection. In fact, you can even get more. For example, you can prove the partial regularity theory for our 3D model equations. You can also prove surface criteria, beyond Katamaida's criteria, and I believe that we can do more. Despite the striking semantic and the theoretical level, the 3D model has a completely different numerical behavior from that of the Lewis group equations. Very recently, Ho, Su, and Wang also obtained the similarities of the 3D model in some very special case, analytically. Here is some numerical. Here we show some numerical potential similarities of our 3D model. We monitor the infinity log of U1. U1 is defined by U theta over R. It has the same scaling as all the vorticity. So this is a convergence study. You can see that the convergence is very good. And the infinity log of U1 grows very rapidly. The rate is much beyond the double exponential rate. And if you use the numerical solutions of the 3D model at the time t, very close to the same singularity as the initial data of the original Stokes equation, you can find that the error infinite norm, the error infinite norm of U1 decreases rapidly. So the numerical behavior of our state free model, the original Stokes equation, is totally different. We also want to understand the mechanism of singularities. In the model equation, you can see that in part Z to C1 is parallel to U1, then you have very bad non-linearity and you get block, final time block. And this can be seen in the numerical analysis. Here you can see that the maximum U1 and C1Z as the support of these two quantities has very big overlap. As time evolves, we still have overlap. But if you use the numerical solutions of the 3D model as the data of the original Stokes equations, you find that the overlap decreases. And when U1 goes larger and larger, C1Z is very close to zero. So the only difference between our 3D model and the reformulated Mayer Stokes equations in terms of these new variables is that we neglect the convection effect in the model. So, in some sense, we show that the convection seems to play state level effect. And last, I also want to show an example of MHE, which shows that the convection plays a stabilizing effect. This is the incompatible dynamic dynamic equations, and we found that the resolved coefficients in the velocity field equations and the magnetic field equations are equal. Other components are not very important, all of them are positive. So for simplicity, we just take them one. In general, it is not expected to have better reference theory for the MAP system than those existing ones for the Lewis Stokes equations, since the Lewis Stokes equations can be considered as the special case of the MAP systems. For example, you take the magnetic field to be a constant vector, then you recover Lewis Stokes equations from MHT. However, if you notice that the convection term in MHT equation may play a stabilizing effect, you can get some very special global dipole theories for MHT equations. Here, we assume that Q is bigger than 3 and less than 9, and 2 over P plus 3 over Q equal to 1, and then there exists this absolute constant delta and kappa, such that MHD equation admits a unique local source origin in the space if the image data satisfies this assumption. Here, the image velocity could be arbitrary line in L3 space. And then you just need to well prepare the initial magnetic field so that the difference of H0 and the U0 is very small in L3 space. This is due to a very simple observation. Which are the solutions of heat equations, you see that this is the special solution of the MHD equation. This is due to the conservation of convection in the velocity field and the stretching in velocity field. And also in the equation of magnetic field, this term also cancels with this term. You can think of this term as stretching. It is exactly the same equation as that of the vorticity equation. So they just cancel. But the consequence is that for any given smooth image data, L0 and L3, there exists a force F, such that various smooth equations with the force F and the image data U0 will make a unique global strong solution. So you just need to prepare force so that the latest Lucas equation is going very close. And maybe you also want to do this in the space of BML1:1. Unfortunately, this is still open till now. But we can do some similar results in the space of Bayesian space. And it is also very interesting for us. But still open that if the coefficients are not equal, how to do this? Okay, this. All. Thank you.